thank you to each and everybody, you know, everyone that's here. I think I've had an amazing evening, and I, you know, I have seen so much passion and just so much talent on this stage tonight. And you know, I think it's down to me to make sure that this theatre is actually filled next Drama Festival, because I think anyone that misses out is really missing out on an amazing week of so much talent. So I will make sure that we will have people on these seats next year, I can assure you, and that we all win it. And I will do, I cannot promise anything, because I would not be a politician if I said could, but I will do everything in my power to make sure that this actually happens, because I know, I'm going to talk about the diary, because I have never been so moved. I just sat there and I was shocked and I went through so many emotions, but I want to see that in every one of our secondary schools. Yeah. And
with the size of the audiences, but the wonderful thing about it is the people who were here were so supportive of the actors, and I think the actors appreciated that, and they rose to the occasion. It's been a lovely selection of stuff, lovely different styles, some very, very exciting productions. The one tonight, the youth production, was very innovative. The two plays that came first and second in the full length section had been beautifully directed by directors who really knew what the text was about and understood the rise and fall, the highs and lows within the writing. And you know, we were captivated by both of them. They both should have won, really.
You what's the hardest part about being an adjudicator then, when it comes to the Saturday night and the deciding?
It's trying to get a balanced judgment. Fortunately, we've got a lot of criteria that we have to use for each category, and it helps to turn what can sometimes be a very subjective judgment into an objective judgment. And sometimes, you know, I'm quite surprised when I add all the marks up as to where they're going, because some companies are better in one area than they are in another, and it's getting that balance right. What I tend to do. The last category is dramatic achievement, how successful was the performance. And obviously I can't do that on the last night, but during the week I do all my marking when I get back to the hotel, look at my notes, mark the first four sections, I mark the stage presentation, direction and acting. And then I sleep on it. And in the morning I go back to my notes and say, what do I remember about this production? What was the audience's reaction to the production? And that's when I arrive at my mark out of 10 for dramatic achievement. And that's a great leveller, because I find that supposing I thought it was sort of okay, and I end up with a mark, having looked at my notes, I end up with a mark of 5 out of 10 for that last section. My marks should be between 50 and 60, all the other marks when I add them up. If they come to 80 something, then I've done something wrong in one of the categories, probably. And so that's a great leveller. And I think most adjudicators appreciate the fact that they've got this check that stops them reacting too emotively to a production.
You travel up and down the country at various festivals. You just said that this was very poorly attended. So becoming a quite a a familiar scene?
It is a bit now. The one-act festivals particularly, people don't want to go and see one-act plays. The full-length festivals tend to be better. The ones in... I find the ones further away from London are better attended. The ones up in the northeast of England are usually packed out. I mean, I did Richmond at the beginning of this year, the Georgian Theatre in Richmond, and it was packed every night. Festivals in Ireland, wonderful attendance, always. But the nearer you get to London, I think it's because you've got so much theatre on your doorstep, people don't come out to see amateurs, which I think is an awful shame, because there's some wonderful stuff going on.
So thank you very much. Okay, we hope you enjoyed your time here.
Thank you very much. Had a lovely